In this video, we're going to talk about ransomware. What is it? How does it look when it shows up? How should you deal with it? What should you do to protect your own data and your business? G'day, Dan. How are you?
Good, thanks, Tim.
So ransomware, it seems to be popping up more and more. I'm hearing stories. Almost everyone has had an experience or knows someone who's had an experience. How common is the ransomware problem?
Unfortunately, ransomware is becoming more and more common, and yeah, you will hear more and more stories about it, particularly recently as more businesses are using their computers. You'll hear more about it.
All right, so let's start with a definition. What is ransomware?
So ransomware is when the files on your computer have been encrypted, so they've been locked down. Unfortunately, you don't have the key to open up that lock. So generally, the key is held by somebody outside of your trusted circle, yeah. So a hacker or somebody outside.
When we talk about these people, I mean, it sort of seems very odd, but I mean, are they, I want to say, sitting in a, you know, in a suburb in Sydney? Are they overseas? Who are these people? I mean, there seems to be so many of them.
So we refer to them as hackers that have encrypted your data. So the hackers can be sitting in any location. They could be sitting in the room next door, they could be sitting in the same suburb, but more often than not, they're sitting in a country where the policing is not as good as say Australia or the US.
Right, so they're somewhere remote and they've come after you and your data. How does that actually unfold? Something called a pop-up is important. How do you handle a computer pop-up if it starts saying ransomware has arrived?
So once you see the ransomware pop-up come up on the screen, it's generally a red window that says your computer has now been infected. And the indication that it's ransomware is that you have to pay some kind of ransom to be able to get your data back.
Right.
So to be able to get that key to unlock your data, you generally need to pay the cyber criminals some kind of money, whether it's a couple of $100s or I've heard of reports of tens of thousands of dollars that the cyber criminals demand to be able to get your data back.
Have you, I mean, you probably have experience here. Is it worth paying them? Should you not pay them? What's the first thing that you should do?
Yeah, to coin a very, very American phrase is we don't pay the ransoms. And that's what we would say to businesses is that you generally don't pay the ransom because there's no guarantee that you will get the key to unlock your data. So we would then look at ways that we can get the customer's data back without paying the ransom, which is when we need to go to good backups and also multiple copies of the backups. Not only a backup in their office, but a backup they might have off-site, whether it's on a hard drive at home or whether it's in the cloud somewhere.
Okay, good. So let's talk about how to protect your computer from these sorts of threats. How can you set yourself up on a PC or as a business to really be protected in that way you're talking about?
The first thing I would say to people is don't click on the link.
Right.
Now, if you've accidentally
avoid the problem. Yeah.
If you've accidentally clicked on the link, then what you need to do is turn that machine off and isolate it from the network, and just make sure that no other computers around you are infected. So once you've checked to make sure that everyone is safe and that the outbreak has stopped, then you need to look at ways that you can restore the data back onto your machine. So
setting up, therefore, looks like making sure that your data is well backed up. What sort of time, if you're well backed up and everything's going, what sort of time can it take to restore a backup if, let's say, they've signed up with you guys and got everything working around? About how long does it take to sort this stuff out?
If your data is backed up and it's fairly accessible, it can take just a few minutes to get your system back up and running. Unfortunately, if you have a lot of data and it's stored in a place that may not be as accessible, it could take days or even weeks.
And you're offline for that whole period of time.
That's right. You're without your data.
What is computer spam and how is it related to ransomware, or is it related to ransomware?
Spam is all the email that comes into your inbox that you don't want. Then when we talk about these emails, it's more of a, what we call a phishing email. So that's phishing with a PH. So when the email comes in to you, into you, it might come up as spam, but it's really just trying to entice you to click on a link. And when you click on that link, that's when all the trouble can happen and you can be locked out of your files.
All right, good, got it. So is there anything else that people should do to prepare their business for the eventuality, that hopefully never happens, of ransomware?
Good passwords, good backups, and also good anti-spam, anti-virus software is what we say to people. If you take those steps, you're generally limiting your chances of being infected by ransomware.
All right, terrific. Thanks very much. For those of you who'd like to find out more or perhaps speak with Dan directly, please reach out online through the website sabervox.com.au.